Thank you for your kind introduction, and thank you for the committee for letting me speak at this conference. So I'm going to talk about elective cesarean section in Belgian Blues and the complications we see thereafter. And the reason why I'm going to talk about elective cesarean sections is because in Belgium the predominant breed, the beef breed, is the Belgian Blue. As you can see on the right side, and since the introduction of artificial insemination in the 1950s, it was noticed that some animals of this breed gave more muscular offspring, and of course people were interested in that because the calves were bigger, they had more meat, and that was economically very interesting. But only much later it was shown that this was actually because of a natural genetic mutation in the myostatin gene, and you got hypermuscular, double-muscled animals, so it's a muscular hypertrophy. And of course, that was very interesting because it's economical, because of its economical value. Only in the 1970s, there was a distinction between the double-purpose Belgian Blue, you can see on the left side, and the double-muscled Belgian Blue on the right side. So they are genetically the same, apart from the myostatin gene. And of course, because the double-purpose breed is not that muscular, the milk production is not as high as in Holsteins, people started selecting more for the hypermuscular type, you see on the right. And because of that, there is a very high degree of dystocia, since there is a very large degree of fetal-maternal disproportion. So that means that the calves are relatively too big for the pelvis of the mother. And that is why that elective cesarean sections are performed in almost 95% of the cases, because the outcome with a live calf and a live cow is much higher than when we have natural birth. And that is why that we perform a lot of cesarean sections at our reproductive clinic, 300 to 400 a year, and at our ambulatory clinic around 600. And that is because we need good surgical skills, our students need good surgical skills, because an elective cesarean section has become a daily operation we perform in Belgian practice. In the left picture you can see Belgian Blue heifer calf with the skeleton depicted in her. So you can see that she has a large pelvic area, but it's not because of the skeleton, it's because her pelvis area is very muscular, and you can also see that the shoulder area is more muscled. And on the right picture you can see a Belgian Blue cow that's calved for the second time, and a calf that is a few hours old. It is a very large cow, but her pelvis is not big enough to get the calf out, so that is why we perform a cesarean section. Since it is still an invasive surgery, we need good, excellent surgical skills to minimize postoperative complications, because they can seriously impair fertility or even the next cesarean section that will be performed. And that is why the aim of our study was to see what the occurrence was of postoperative complications. So all cesarean sections are performed according to a standard protocol that was described by Iris Kolkman in 2007. All cesarean sections are performed by one graduated veterinarian and with the aid of two or sometimes three students, because they need to learn how to perform the cesarean section. So on the left side you can see a Belgian Blue heifer being prepped for a cesarean section in our surgery room. In the middle picture you can see the veterinary surgeon in the front and two students in the back scrubbing in for surgery. And on the right side you can actually see two students closing up the cow after cesarean section. So they do actively participate in the cesarean section. And of every surgery that we do, we make a surgery report with information about the cow. So what is her parity? What's the cervical dilation? So we always perform a pre-surgical vaginal examination. And all information about the cesarean section itself is reported. The cows stay for about 3 days after a cesarean section at our clinic, so we do have information about complications after the cesarean section. A cow never goes home if she is sick, so if she stays for 10 days because something went wrong, we did have information for those 10 days about possible complications. And the thing we were most interested in actually was the postoperative adhesions. Because these can seriously impair the next cesarean section. And we based ourselves on the previous cesarean section. So we looked at one cow that came back for 1, 2, 3, sometimes 4 times, but that we could say 1 year after another which adhesions appeared or did not appear. As for the results, so as I showed, we had an input of 1,081 cesarean sections. We only included live-born calves, so that left us with 1,053 cesarean sections. And the complications we saw most was retained fetal membrane. We took a cutoff point of 12 hours. There is discussion whether to take 24 hours or not, but we took 12 hours, and we saw that almost 24% of the animals did have retained fetal membranes. And second most appearing complication is wound emphysema or skin emphysema. And we also recorded fever in about 14% of the cases, and the fever was not always related with retained fetal membranes, for example. So sometimes there was fever, but nothing else. And the more severe complications we see, so being wound infection, wound dehiscence, so that's the opening of the wound because of the infection, hemorrhage, peritonitis, or even death, occurred luckily in only 9%. So for example, the death and the peritonitis was 0.2%, so that's luckily not that much. So that's a smaller portion of the complications we see. For the postoperative adhesions, a little bit more difficult slide. So we only used cows that had at least one previous cesarean section, because of course, normally a heifer that didn't have a cesarean section before shouldn't have adhesions. So that was more than half of the cows that came in. And of these animals, we did see that 35% had adhesions, intra-abdominal adhesions. It could be adhesions between the rumen and the abdominal wall, which are the ones that are most present, but also between the abdominal wall and the uterus, or the uterus and the rumen. So we divided the complications, the adhesions in severe or mild. The mild ones are the ones involving the rumen. The severe ones are the ones involving the uterus. So of these 562 animals that had at least one previous cesarean section, 63% came back for a subsequent cesarean section. So we did see them year after year. And in these animals, we could see 8.9% with severe adhesions, meaning involving the uterus. This is a picture of a Belgian blue crossed animal. So this is not a Belgian blue animal from the double muscle type. And she has retained fetal membranes. And this is a Belgian blue heifer with skin emphysema. It's a little bit difficult to make a picture of it, but I think you can see there's slight bulging on the left and the right side of the skin incision. To discuss skin emphysema, we do see this as a normal complication. So it's not painful for the cow, and they are not sick. They don't have fever because of it. Surprisingly, we do see it more in heifers. Well, not that surprisingly, because the layers of the muscles and the skin are not adhered yet. In a cow that had a previous cesarean section, there is adhesions, there is scar tissue, so there is less air that possibly might go between the layers. And we also see it more in less experienced vets. So probably because the closing of the abdomen is still a little bit more difficult for the newly graduated vets. The amount of retained fetal membranes is a cause for concern, so it's 24% almost, because this might lead to a severe or maybe not that severe metritis and even peritonitis, because we did make an incision in the uterus. And severe postoperative adhesions, so the ones involving the uterus, they might have a negative impact on the future fertility and the subsequent cesarean section. Probably the amount that I told you, 8.9%, is an underestimation because we don't have information about all cows. Not all cows come back for the next cesarean section because maybe they were culled, maybe they didn't get pregnant again, or maybe the next cesarean section was performed at home. So we don't know about all the animals. To conclude, luckily, severe postoperative complications such as peritonitis, death, and wound infection are seldom. And we can teach elective cesarean section to our undergraduate students with minimal risk. So that's it. Thank you for your attention. Arigato. And I will take questions.